Hello and welcome to Queens Public Library. My name is Joanne and I'm one of the librarians at the Hunters Point branch. Before we begin today's program, just a few notices. QPL is open for to-go service, so you can pick up and return materials at many locations. In addition, select QPL locations are actually in stage two of our reopening plan, which offers browsing, computer use, and in-person reference services that have already started. To learn more about stage two, see our virtual program calendar, access digital services, or get an e-card, please visit queenslibrary.org. And this year, QPL is also celebrating our 125th anniversary. So look out for special programs, challenges, book lists, and more. We are proud to have served the people of Queens since 1896, providing our customers with the resources they need to advance in their lives. We also want to mention that this program is part of a series for the Hunters Point Environmental Education Center that will be happening periodically on Thursdays at 4 p.m. on YouTube Live. So do keep an eye out for upcoming programs. And if you enjoyed today's program, we will also have another fishing-related program on June 26th at 2 p.m. this Saturday, The Underwater City, Life Within the East River. And so check the comments as we'll be shortly adding those links in there. These programs are made possible by the Newtown Creek Environmental Benefit Fund, administered by City Parks Foundation and funded by the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation. And so onto the event today. We are joined by Steve Wong and Melissa Cohen from the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation Bureau of Fisheries, and Devin Gorson from the Environmental Education Department of the New York State Parks in the New York City region. And they're here to introduce new and current anglers to freshwater and saltwater fishing New York City locations, rules and regulations, skills, web resources to help anglers get started, and answer any of your questions. So if you have any questions for our presenters, please write them in the live chat as they'll be answering them in the event. So take it away, Melissa and Steve and Devin.
Okay, thank you everyone for joining us. It's really exciting to be here. As Joanne just said, are going to do a presentation on fishing in New York City, how to get started, some important information. So we do have an agenda that we can show you that's got a number of things on it. Do you want to go to the next slide, Steve? Thank you. So we're going to go, I'm not going to read every single one of these things, but these are the general topics that we're going to cover today. I would like to mention that if you have the materials that you picked up from the library, make sure you have some string. I think you might have had some in your packages, the sketty. If you did not get a package, maybe take some time and grab a piece of string because we're going to be tying a couple of knots today. And also helpful with the knots would be a paper clip, or this is one of those, sorry, I'm not holding right, the binder clip. But this is will function as a hook, a pretend hook. So we do have a question for you. Next slide, please. You're going to be using the comments box to answer this question. And also, I should mention now that if you do have any questions during the presentation, please write them into the comment section and we will do our best to answer them for you. So this question is, have you ever fished before? This means freshwater or saltwater. So it could be at the beach, off a pier, or maybe you went to a pond or a lake to fish. Just please type that in. You can even just say yes or no. So if you have ever fished before, hopefully you still get some good information here because we are going to cover fresh and saltwater fishing. If you have not fished before, hopefully this will get you started and get you interested in fishing. So let's go to the next slide. Okay, so we can go back to the fish. So if whether or not have fished, you might have run into one of these species. These are some more popular fish species that we have in the city, and these include saltwater and freshwater. Okay, you can go to the next slide, please. We're going to talk about a few saltwater fish species because we do have in New York City, saltwater that changes in salinity. It does lead to having a really big diversity of fish. So these are just a few of the more common ones. There are actually thousands of more fish that pass through this pass through the East River, the Hudson River. We have summer flounder is also known as fluke, which you might have heard of, bluefish, sea bass, porgy, and blackfish. And the two that I left out are the striped bass and American eel. And that's because these guys are super special fish. They can actually spend time in freshwater and saltwater. So when I say freshwater, I'm speaking of lakes or ponds or rivers. So the striped bass can actually hang out in the ocean, and most of the time that's where it is. But when it's time to spawn or have young, have babies, it goes into the rivers to spawn. The American eel also does something similar, only it's the exact opposite. The American eel spends a lot of time in rivers and streams, and we find them in lakes too, all around the city. And then when it's time to have babies, they go out to the Atlantic Ocean, to the Sargasso Sea, and they find a mate, they have babies, and the babies come right back up into the rivers, and the cycle begins again. So I have to also mention some of our more common freshwater species, which should be on the next slide. So these guys, again, we do have more freshwater species than are listed here in New York City, but I have to say that not anywhere near as many as our saltwater fish species. The guy on the top left, largemouth bass, is a top predator, and that happens to be the most popular freshwater sport fish throughout the entire state of New York. Bluegill sunfish and the pumpkin seed sunfish all the way on the right, those are super popular. So if you're going to a lake or a pond and you put a worm on a hook and you dunk it for a little while and you get pull up a fish, you get a bite, pull up fish, it's probably going to be a bluegill sunfish, more than likely. It might not be, but they're just, bluegill is like our most popular freshwater fish species in New York City. We also have brown bullhead catfish. You might have heard of catfish before. There's over 300 different species of catfish. In New York City, the one we find the most is brown bullhead, and those are in our lakes and ponds. A couple other species, yellow perch, black crappie, and common carp, which actually was brought over in, I think, the 1800s to our country, but it's been around for so long, and there's so many people dedicated to fishing for it. It's almost like it's almost like a native, even though it's not. Okay, go to the next slide, please. Okay, this is the part where I had you get your string ready. This is going to be a knot that you're going to tie. Hopefully you can join me in doing this. This type of knot, it's called an improved clinch knot. And this is used for attaching your line, which is just basically the string that's on a fishing rod, to the hook. So this is my pretend hook. So what you're going to do is, in number one, you're going to take the line and put it through the circle in your hook and pull through a couple inches. I have to pull through more because my line is really thick. Then what you're going to do in number two, you're going to take the line and wrap it around the main line about five times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. And then as you see in number three, you take the end of this line and put it through the loop that's closest to the hook. Put it right through there. And then you have this giant loop here. You just put the end through that giant loop. And then what you do is you start to pull and also slide this knot down towards the top of the hook. If you are using monofilament fishing line, people will sometimes lick it, wet it a little bit to make it slide smoother and get a little tighter. I'm not going to do that with my shoelace. So here we have the clinch knot. It's not the most beautiful knot, but it's going to hold. And if you're doing this, you're actually going fishing and you have this end here sticking off, just clip it off with some clippers or a knife or something. So that's the improved clinch knot. Practice it, because it's a really good one to have. And you can watch this video, and there's also tons of other videos online that you can check out too. So I guess we can go to the next slide. Okay, have you seen anyone fishing in New York City? I see people all the time fishing in New York City. Even when I'm not on the job, I see people fishing. So we have lots of places to fish in the city, lots of shoreline. And this is another thing that we hopefully you've gotten our in your package. This is a New York City fishing map. It shows a lot of different locations to fish. We have tons of coastline and we have a few lakes and ponds. So there's a lot of locations. There are, and there actually different categories too. So we can maybe go to the next slide and I can go through them. So one type is the beach, just go out to the ocean, maybe Rockaway Beach or Coney Island. We have rocks and jetties, which actually, if you are at Coney Island or you're out in the Rockaways, you might see a rock jetty. Something to be careful about if you haven't been on one before, because there are waves breaking on them and there are rocks. So piers might be a really good place to start, just because when you're standing on a pier, you're just fishing right over the railing and you're not, it's not too dangerous to walk around on it. Promenade is the same way. That's basically like east along the East River and the Hudson River. Just there's tons of shoreline access right there. So those are locations throughout the city. You could go on a boat if you're really lucky. Like some people I know, you can go out on a boat and catch fish, which is very cool. And we have lakes and ponds, and that's the freshwater locations that I referred to before. And those in New York City, you're not allowed to put boats on them. I think because if a lot of people did that, it could be kind of dangerous. But there's lots of shoreline that you can use to access the fish in lakes and ponds. So you could go to the next slide. Thank you. So as I mentioned before, this map has a lot of those locations in it. It has like this kind of a blow up section that kind of highlights a few areas, but then there's a lot of places that are not highlighted necessarily, but there is information on how to get there, what types of amenities are there, like bathrooms is a really important thing. Maybe you're actually probably a lot of people are going to be using public transportation. So we made an effort to make sure there's train and bus lines on here too, so that you could just get on public transportation and get to these locations. And then some of the fish species I mentioned earlier are also on this map. If you look in the top right, you'll see common saltwater and common freshwater fish species that are listed there. So there's also some contact information there if you need to get in touch with us, if you need to find out about regulations, which Steve's going to talk to you about a little bit later. That's on this map as well. And so you're looking at one side on this slide, but there's actually another whole side to it too, which is map. So there's a lot of good information on it. So hopefully you got one in your packet. If you don't, coming soon, we're going to have a place where you can actually write to us and we'll be able to send you one. So you could go to the next slide. So just to talk about some of these places, we're going to talk more about Gantry later. Deb's going to mention it, but Gantry Plaza State Park, right next to the Queens Library. It's a great place to fish. And here's one of the fish that I mentioned. These people are both holding fluke or summer flounder. It's a pier, so it's nothing too treacherous. You just go out there and put your line in the water. And maybe you'll catch a fluke. There's also other types of fish species there as well, though. So that's Gantry. We can go to the next slide. Okay, here's freshwater spot. This is a pond or a lake. There are differences between lakes and ponds. And I think it's generally the more shallow areas. Ponds are more shallow and the light penetrates all the way to the bottom. So I think that pretty much covers most of New York City's lakes and ponds. So there are more ponds than lakes, but they do still have names like lakes. So here's Van Cortlandt Lake. The woman in the middle has a largemouth bass, which I mentioned before. And then on the right, that's a catfish. So it's this, again, you can kind of see it in the photo. There's a lot of shoreline access there. There are bathrooms there too, and it's accessible by the one train. And there's even parking if you had a vehicle and you wanted to drive there. Okay, next slide, please. Prospect Park Lake in Brooklyn. This is a really beautiful lake with lots of shoreline access and a lot of different types of shoreline too. And bat bass in the middle is really a fish that came from Prospect Park Lake. It's really quite huge. The woman on the right is holding a bluegill sunfish, which I mentioned earlier as being a very popular freshwater fish. Again, Prospect Park is accessible by public transportation. There's a number of trains that go there. Okay, next slide, please. Harlem Mere in Central Park is another great place to fish. The Harlem Mere has, it's smaller than Prospect by a lot, but there's tons of shoreline access and there are so many fish there. It's a great place to take kids. That you really, you could get away with using bread or you could, I was going to say corn. I mean, that's a possibility, but worms are the best thing to use if you're going freshwater fishing. But like I said, you could use corn or you could use bread or even I've seen people use hot dogs as well. I recommend worms. So if you get your hands on worms, then you're going to do really well there. I don't know if you'll catch that giant bass though that's in the picture, but you never know. Okay, next slide, please. Ocean Breeze Pier on Staten Island is super cool. This is a really beautiful, nice big pier that goes out into Raritan Bay on Staten Island. Not as easy to get to through public transportation, but you could do it. I believe you would if you're, depending on where you're coming from, you end up getting, I think, on a bus as your last part of your trip there. But you can catch all kinds of fish there. It depends on the time of year. But again, it's not very treacherous to just walk up to the pier with your fishing rod and just, you know, soak your bait in the water. So, okay, next slide, please. Okay, so we're switching over to Steve. So he's got the real important information here. So take it away, Steve.
All righty. Thank you, Melissa. So I'm going to show you how to tie a complete rig. And this rig is really useful for saltwater fishing. Freshwater fishing, I would actually use a different rig, but for general saltwater fishing, if you're just trying to target anything, this is a great rig to start with. So if you look at my number two, there's something called a surgeon's loop, and the surgeon's loop creates a loop where you can attach a hook. Now below that number two, there's another surgeon's loop that makes a loop that you can put a weight on there. So I'm going to show you the surgeon's loop so that you can tie this in complete bottom rig. Oops. Okay, great. So grab your string and let me find the end of my string. Cool. So this is my opposite. This is the end of my string. The other end goes up to my fishing line. And what I want to do is just double the fishing line over on itself. So I doubled it on itself and this portion right here is what is going to create the loop. So I can make a really big loop if I want, or I can make a really small one. But today for this bottom rig, actually I want to make kind of a large loop. So I'm going to start with about 8 inches to 12 inches. Next thing I want to do after I double it over is I want to pinch my fingers together and transfer the line to just one finger. So I have doubled over. And I'm going to call this the end loop, and I'm going to call this the middle loop. Okay. I'm going to show you underneath my fingers what's going on. Okay, hopefully you can see that. So it's crossed over. Now what I want to do is I want to take the end loop, and I want to go through the middle loop. So make sure to cross over the line. If I go backwards, the knot will untie itself. So I created this middle loop, taking the end loop, and I'm going through that middle loop. I do it once, I'm going to let go just so you can see it, and then I'm actually going to go twice. So two times, and then I'm going to pull the end loop, and I'm going to pull the rest of these two lines, and it's going to cinch the knot. So I'm just going to go ahead and close that up. Shouldn't be any loose parts. Don't cinch it too tight with your line because you might want to untie it and try it again, but that is the surgeon's loop. So what I have on the other end outside of the loop is one kind of long tag end that should go down to my weight. And then this side up here on the top goes to the tip of my fishing rod. And now what I do next is you guys have your paper clip. And the paper clip represents my hook, the eye of the hook, the circle. How you put this hook onto the surgeon's loop is you put the double line or the loop through the eye of the hook. So it kind of looks like this. Then I open up the loop and I bring the hook through that loop, sort of like this. And when I give it a nice little pull, there we go. I have the hook on the end of my surgeon's loop. what I'm going to do is I'm going to tie one more sturgeons on the bottom so I can attach a weight. So I'm going to do that very quickly. One, two, and I didn't give myself a lot of lead, but I made a little loop and my hook is coming off. You see it? Okay, cool. So that's my hook down here. Oh, sorry, this is my hook here, and then this is where my weight goes. Typically, I like to have the hook not able to touch the weight, so I want this a little bit further away so they don't really get spun and tangled. So that's how you do a bottom rig. Cool, I'm gonna talk about the rules and regulations. Anytime you go fishing, you should always check the regulations first. So if you are 16 years or older, you need a New York State fishing license, and that's for freshwater. That is a yearly fee. If you're a New York State resident, it's $25. And if you go fishing in saltwater, even the Hudson River in certain areas, especially down in the city, that is still marine. So you need the recreational marine fishing registry. That's actually free. You can find that on our website, dec.ny.gov, and you just go ahead and register and you'll get this saltwater fishing license. The regulations can change each year and they can change or differ by the area and species. So again, make sure that you go on our website anytime you go fishing because you should be updated with all this information. So on the freshwater side, there are special regulations for New York City, and I'm looking on the right-hand side. Maybe you can see my pointer. Okay, great. So DEC, the regulations are that you need a freshwater fishing license, as we discussed, and it's catch and release only. So New York City Parks has additional regulations on top of our DEC ones, which are no lead weights, no barbed hooks, and no stainless steel hooks. So as long as you follow all of these regulations, you can fish in freshwater in New York City. Cool. So in saltwater, if you're keeping fish, if you're 16 years or older and you have the marine registry, actually under is you don't need the marine registry. If the fish is in season and it is the correct size, one can keep fish. You should be aware that there are Department of Health advisories for fish consumption, and you can find all that information on www.health.ny.gov. And this changes by location of where you catch the fish, which species are consumed, and the person, so by age and gender. And I just have one of the pages from their website, and this is the water body of where you catch the fish. It defines by different areas. And we are looking at New York City, Lower Bay, Ocean, and Sound. So if you look at this little image, it's south of the Verrazano and all of this whole area, including Jamaica Bay. So that is the water body. So the regulate or the advisory for fish, we could see the different species here. And let's just say you caught a striped bass and it's the right size and the right season. If you are a man over 15 and women over 50, you can have 4 meals per month. One meal is just about the size of your hand, so or size of your palm, I apologize. But women under 50 and children under 15, they should only have up to one meal per month of striped bass. So just be aware of where you catch the fish, the species, and who you are. Check out the DOH website and you can see if it's kind of safe to eat or not safe to eat and how much you should eat or not eat. All right, so this is a great resource for the beginner angler. It is something called our iFish New York Getting Started Fishing in New York City, saltwater, and we have a freshwater version as well. This PDF lives on our website. So if you go on our dec.ny.gov, you can find this somewhere in there. It's got all the information you need to know, what rod to buy, what reel, what pound test, the knots you should tie, the rigs, everything you need to know is just to get started is in this resource. I would highly recommend if you haven't fished before, check this out. It's super awesome. And I just want to zoom in on one particular part of this pamphlet or PDF, and it is the fishing checklist. So anytime you go fishing, make sure you have all this material, virtually all of this material, because they're very essential to, you know, properly fishing. So you need the rod, the reel, the line, the bait, hooks and sinkers. Make sure you don't forget those pliers. I'm not going to go through everything, but just take a look at this checklist before you go. And it's really, really helpful. All right. So setting up a saltwater rod. Actually, Joanne, can we go into my view? Thank you so much. So setting up a saltwater rod, I have a spinning rod right here. This isn't a saltwater grade rod, but it is a spinning. It's the same as that you would use in saltwater, except saltwater would be larger. But I'm just going to show you some of the components and how to set this thing up. So we have the line on the spool. The spool is here. This thing is called the bail. It controls the line going, letting the line go or reeling it in. And this is the handle. So how I set this guy up is I put the reel onto the rod by this little thing called the reel seat. I attach it on there. Next thing I want to do is I want to take the line and put it through all of the guides or eyes and then set up a rig. So how I do that is, before just putting the line into the guides, I have to open this wire bail. So make sure to open it, take the line and put it through all of the guides, all the way up, don't miss any, and then come back. When I'm done, I close the bail and I'm ready to go. So that is actually very easy and how I set the line up and the rod. Then you tie this rig for saltwater. The different weights that you use just depends on where you're fishing, and the different size hooks also depends on where you're fishing. Check out our beginner's guide to saltwater fishing and we'll give you a little overview. Now just talking about bait. Bait is super important. Let's just start with the saltwater. If you're just trying to catch anything, fresh clams, mussels, bloodworms, sandworms, or lugworms are all, I would highly recommend just the general bait for you to use. If the larger fish are around in the right season, bunker or Atlantic menhaden is a great alternative bait to target these larger fish. Most of these bait here you can find in a tackle shop or a bait shop, and they're spread around the city. But in a pinch, if you can't make it over to, you know, Sheepshead Bay or wherever it is, try some squid from the market. Hopefully it's fresh and it's not frozen. Or if you're on the sand, really highly recommend mole crabs, or I call them sand crabs. And they work great for bait as well. In the freshwater side, Melissa kind of covered these things before. Night crawlers is the number one bait because they can catch virtually every fish in all of our lakes and ponds. In a pinch, you can use corn or a piece of a hot dog, bread dough, white bread. You can wad it up on a small hook, or even the raw bread dough will all work. But these ones in a pinch will only catch certain species and not all of the species. So if you're trying to catch those big largemouth bass that we saw earlier, I would say probably most all of these won't catch the largemouth bass. So if you want to catch all species, go for the night crawlers and earthworms. Okay, I'm gonna show you how to cast in my small apartment here. So this is our spinning rod. It's kind of set up. This isn't real line. It's just some rope that I put in there so you can see. And how to cast is that I'm going to look around first, make sure I'm not swinging my hook into someone else. That's very important. So number one, make sure the area is clear. Number two is I want to put my finger out and grab the fishing line and hold it against the fishing rod. I want to hold it tight because once I open this bail, when I let go, the line will just fall. So I have to make sure to hold it tight. So here we go. I'm going to hold the line tight. Next thing I want to do is open that bail, that little wire part. Open it up. I'm ready to go. I'm going to look around behind me. It's all clear. Depending on how you want to do it, you can overhand cast, like kind of over your head, or you can do it on the side. I'm going to do it overhand because it's easier for you guys to see. And I'm still holding the fishing line. I'm going to draw it back slowly, the rod. And then I'm going to swing the rod and let go at about 11 o'clock. So I'm going to swing. My finger is going to go up right about here. If I go up too early here, the weight will go kind of straight up and down. If I go a little too late out here, the weight's going to go kind of straight down. So you can kind of fine tune where you let it go for the optimal distance. So I'm going to go over my head. I'm going to cast, and I'm going to let go right about there. And there we go. Cast. Once I'm throw the line out or cast, I'm going to close the bail and then turn the handle until it's kind of tight and you can feel the weight, and then you're fishing. All right, so quick summary. We went over the common fish species, salt and freshwater, that you can catch in our lakes and ponds and around New York City. We also have some fishing locations that we covered, and you should definitely check out our New York City fishing map. You can always email us for one if we might be able to send it out to you. Sometimes we put it into some tackle shops and you can pick one up. Always check our website. There's tons of resources out there to get you started fishing in the city and around the state. We went over the rules and regulations. If you're over 16 and you're fishing freshwater, get the freshwater fishing license. If you're fishing saltwater, you can get the recreational marine fishing registry. Always check the regulations when you go fishing, as they can change, especially outside of New York City and the ocean. If you're going to consume a fish and it's the right season and size and all that, check out the health advisories for safe consumption of fish at the Department of Health, health.ny.gov. And you learned about bait, how to tie knots, a bottom rig, setting up a rod, and casting. And that will get you fishing. If you just follow all those things, check out our resources, you can get set up pretty easily. All right, so next we have Devin. She is going to talk about free fishing opportunities with New York State parks. So, Devin, y'all ready?
All right. Hi, everyone. First of all, I just want to briefly thank the Hunters Point Library and Steve and Melissa for putting together this awesome program. And I wanted to thank you all for joining us today. I hope that this has inspired some of you to try your hand at fishing in New York City. My name is Devin Gorson, and I'm one of the environmental educators for New York State Parks here in New York City. And for those of you who don't know, we actually have a New York State Park right here in Long Island City, right outside of the Hunters Point Library, as I think Melissa mentioned before. And that is Gantry Plaza State Park. So if you live in the area or if you visited the library before, you may recognize the park from some of these photos. Gantry Plaza State Park is one of three of our state parks located on the East River, and it's one of eight of our New York State parks throughout the five boroughs of New York City. So I bring up Gantry specifically today because it is one of our parks where we actually have a public fishing pier. So anyone is welcome to come out and fish as long as you have your marine fishing license that Steve and Melissa both mentioned. And actually, fun fact, this weekend, this program today is quite timely because this weekend, June 26th and June 27th, is actually free fishing weekend here in New York State, which means that you can actually go out and try out fishing without, you know, spending the money on a fishing license if you're going freshwater fishing. So it's exciting and it's a great way to get started and see how you like it before you really commit to getting the license and getting all of the equipment. If you are interested in learning how to fish, but not quite ready to go out on your own, I am here today to tell you about a few different fishing opportunities, free fishing opportunities here at Gantry Plaza State Park and throughout New York City. So if you would go to the next slide, Steve. Gantry Plaza State Park is one of a network of sites throughout the city that offers free fishing clinics for people of all ages. So fishing at the Gantries is the program, and it takes place on most Saturdays from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. in three back-to-back sessions on the hour. So at 10, at 11, and at 12. And we conduct these clinics pretty much throughout the fishing season through October. All of our fishing clinics here at New York State Parks are catch and release, which means that all fish caught are released back into the water. And at our clinics, we also provide all the materials that you'll need, including rods and bait and any of the instructions that you'll need to get started. So it really is a great opportunity to get started without committing to buying all of the equipment that you need first. Just a note, though, that everyone below the age of 18 must come with an adult, and advanced registration is required for these events. And you can register through Eventbrite, which is linked below on this program. You can also find the dates and all registration info at our Eventbrite account for our fishing clinics, as well as for all of our other programs, because we offer a wide variety of programs here at the park and throughout the region. If you are interested in fishing at other sites, maybe you live in Brooklyn or Manhattan or somewhere else in the city, there are a bunch of different organizations that host these free fishing clinics. And DEC actually has a webpage that lists all of the free fishing clinics and how to register, which is also linked below. And they do keep it updated as more clinics come up. So if you wouldn't mind going to the next slide. Now, do we have any young scientists on the program, or people who just generally really like science? Because one of the coolest things that I think about our clinics is that we are actually fishing in the name of science and conservation. So we're out here trying to teach a valuable recreational skill and hobby, and we hope that you really have a lot of fun doing it. But we're also fishing here as part of a big research project. And so Gantry Plaza State Park is part of a network of academic institutions, environmental organizations, government agencies like New York State Parks and DEC, as well as recreational and commercial anglers, people who are out here fishing on a daily basis at our parks and sites along the East River. So every time that we hold a fishing clinic, we make sure to identify and measure every fish that we catch, to submit all of that data to a database that keeps track of all fish caught in the East River in order to better understand the waterway and how we can protect it. And people like you are absolutely critical in our efforts to protect the East River, because if it weren't for you, we really wouldn't be able to collect the amount of data that we're collecting to be able to protect the East River and to get a real snapshot of what's actually living beneath the surface. So next slide. Speaking of life within the East River, if you left this presentation today feeling inspired and curious as to what you might catch or what else lives in this underwater city that is the East River Strait, check out part two of this program on Saturday. One of our educators, Andrew, will be talking about all sorts of different organisms that you can find in the East River. And we'll be showing actual video footage taken right here at Gantry Plaza State Park from everything from the microscopic life and organisms in the East River to some of the fish that you might catch while fishing in the East River. And the program will start at 2 p.m. on Saturday, right here on the Queens Public Library YouTube Live. And we're just really excited. I left some photos there as just a sneak peek of some of the organisms that we're going to talk about. And it'll be a great way to introduce all of you to some of the things that you might see when you're out here on the water. And without further ado, I'm going to pass it back to Steve to end the program.
Great. Thanks, Devin. Thank you, everyone, for joining our program here. Good luck fishing. This is our contact info. If you want to send us an email, if you have any questions about fishing or free fishing or any of the resources that we talked about, we also have Facebook, Twitter, and Flickr. That's here on the screen. And if you have any questions after our presentation, we might hang around a little bit and answer some questions. But otherwise, that is the end of our presentation.
All righty. Thank you so much, everyone, for this amazing presentation. As Steve has said, if you do have questions, please do write them in the live chat as we're going to be answering shortly. I know we actually do have a few questions in there right now. But before we do, I do want to mention that as Melissa and Steve have talked about, there was a program packet that you can get. If you did not get the packet, that is okay. You can still pick them up at the Hunters Point Library, and you can rewatch this event to go through all the activities as well. So feel free to come to the library, pick up one of those packets, and you'll be all good to go. We do want to also once again thank the Newtown Creek Environmental Benefit Fund, administered by the City Parks Foundation and funded by the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation. Please do like and share this video, as this event will be available for viewing after this event. And in addition, subscribe to the QPL channel to get more updates and similar upcoming programs. And the links for the replays, as well as what is going to be upcoming, all of those links are in the chat. And as Devin has mentioned, we do have another program on June 26th, this Saturday at 2 p.m. Links are in the live chat as well. But going on to our audience questions. So our first question actually is, when you are fishing, can you change hands?
I guess I'll answer that. yes, you can change hands. And actually, I have my, let me pick up my spinning reel and rod. So a lot of times I cast with my right hand, and with some rods, I can actually change and reel with my left. And it just really depends on what's most comfortable to you. The spinning reels have, a lot of them have interchangeable sides. So if you like to reel with your right hand, you can set it up for the right. And if you unscrew this cap and change the handle, you can change it to turn the handle with the right or the opposite side. So you can do it however you like, whatever you're most comfortable with.
And so actually I have a follow-up question to that, is that when you are switching hands, is it typically, so I'm thinking of like golfing, is it based on your dominant hand, or what would you say would be the way you would do it? For instance, if I'm dominant in my right hand, where would I normally place it on the pole?
The rhyme or reason with using the right or left hand is a little strange, because with the spinning rod, it's typical to hold it in your right hand and reel with your left. But with a boat rod or a conventional reel, the ones that sit on top that are used on the boat, it's typically the other direction, where the reel is on the and the rod is in your left hand and you're turning with the right. So I you know, it's just about how it's traditionally done, but you can do whatever you'd like, and the spinning rod or reel is interchangeable, as well as the conventional you can get for left and right.
Awesome. Another question, speaking about fishing poles, is where can you get a fishing pole, especially in the city? Where would you be able to get access to one?
Melissa, do you want to take that?
Yes. So you could go to, if you do know where there's a local bait and tackle shop, you could go there and get a rod, or any sporting goods shop, like a large chain sporting goods shop. You can find them online. And I wanted to mention that the brochure that Steve had showed, it was the Getting Started Fishing brochure. Those are on our website, and those have a couple of pointers on where to get a fishing rod.
Awesome. And so it looks like those were our two main questions for today. So just once again, thank you everyone so much for being a part of this presentation. For our viewers who are watching, if you have not picked up one of those activity kits, program kits that we had talked about earlier, they're still available at the branch, and this event will also still be available to rewatch at the same link that you are currently watching at. So thank you everyone so much, and have a wonderful Thursday.